Okay, so coronavirus now doesn't want to stay in my body. That's for sure.
And that's how you protect the drive, not to get damaged from the skid.
Hello guys, so for today we have a crazy project to do. It's involving a chimney breast removal, and that is going to be the entire chimney demolished and taken out. And after, we will have to do some making good. You already saw I started to prepare all the driveway, because I don't want to have any damages. So let's just go, and I will show you and hopefully explain to you step by step exactly what I'm going to do and how hard it's going to be to take the chimney breast out. So most of this job is going to be done just by me. So let's see if just one person is capable of taking the whole chimney down and do it properly. So without further ado, let's just go and do it. So now we are in the loft, and this is our chimney that needs removing. And at the moment I don't have a surface area where I can work from, so I already cut some OSB, and I'm just going to lay it onto these joists so I can sit on them and start doing the demolition. Okay, so I think we are ready. I just done a small platform here just to work on for now. And here is our chimney. It seems that they got a leak of some sort, because everything is falling down. And we can see some runs around here. So we might have a problem with that. Anyway. So maximum that we can go here from the ceiling is 1 meter. So that is our maximum, but I'm just going to go 600, so I'm going to cut all this down and put my bracket, my gully bracket here. Okay, so for now I'm not going to go crazy with power tools, because it's a confined area without any windows and ventilation. And I'm just going to try to do it by hand, or at least this bit that it's in the loft, because I like my air. So I'm going to try to do everything by hand, and this is our first knock. Bigger one. Now the secret is to find the weak spot. If you can find the weak spot, then it's not going to be very hard
to take down. But you have to think, these chimneys, they are they've been built for a long time, and everything is very compact and is going to be hard to break any bricks or to take out any bricks. But once that you do, then it's going to be very easy. You just have to have a little bit of patience at the beginning. And that is our beginning for this journey. Okay, so it wasn't that difficult. We already have taken half of the chimney out. I'm going to try to leave this piece in the center just to sustain it a little bit, but sooner or later I will have to take it out because my metal steel plate is going to go in, and the brackets around here, I will have to fill all these gaps because when I'm going to put my bracket, I want to stay nice and flush with the wall. So yeah, maybe I'm going to take these off, but still I will need to fill some of the gaps. So I'm just going to do that now. Take this one off. I don't know if you can see, there is not much light here, but everything is nice and clean. And I think we can see outside. That needs also blocking at a later stage. If not, all the rain is just going to come through. And we don't want that. So the secret is just find the brick that is loose or the weak point and just take it from there. You just have to clean all along while you are working, because like that you can see any cracks or movements between the bricks and stuff like that. That's how I always do it. I'm just careful on these small details. Once that you clear a little bit the space, it should be easy. So now we are going to go on the other side and take that bit off. Okay, so we've done that. I think it took me about 2 hours, maybe 3. The skip came and is here. And I was just cleaning up everything around here, because everything is broken at the moment. And I think we even went inside the room. It's a hole there. And here also. So yeah, now it's nice and clean. Now I just need to put the bracket on and then start to break downstairs. In this moment, I'm just going to go and buy some materials and then come back and make good few of these holes here. So this surface I need for it to be nice and level, because the bracket is going to be in. And I even done those holes there. Don't know if you can see that. So yeah, I've done a hole here. I created a space, because when the bracket is going to come, the back of it is just going to go inside the wall, and that one is also going to be concreted in. But I'm going to show you all that at a later stage. So yeah, so at the moment I'm just going to go and buy some material, sand and cement. See you in a second. Ready to do some making good. Okay, so on the left side, it was like half of the brick missing. Usually you get that exactly in the points where you need to insert your fixings. So I had to drill all the way through. I put my fixings and I filled everything with sand and cement. And now we just have to wait for that to get hard, so we can fix the bracket. So at this point is not much to do around here. We just have to wait for the cement to go off. And okay. So here is our first bracket that we put in. It's not tied yet. I will tie it up at a later stage, once that all that sand and cement is going to dry. And yeah, everything nice and filled. It's very important, the piece of the bracket at the back that is going to be inserted into the wall and cemented in. Anyway, I left a small gap here, because there is going to stay at a later stage the metal plate. So for now it's just staying like that. So now we just have to go down and just prepare the floors and everything, so I can take the other part down. So let's go. Thank you.
Now the goal is to be dust free. That is kind of hard when you have all that stuff in. I'm just going to try to take it bit by bit out. That is very easy to fill a bucket and very fast. Okay, so right now I've been cleaning. I have taken all the rubbish out. So more than half of the chimney is out. I just need to take out this other small piece, and after that I will have to start chopping it down from the side, because I will need to make good and cluster, and everything has to be on the same level, the old wall with the new wall. Yes, we have taken everything out at the moment. Of course, there are still small bits and pieces to be done, like this one here. Everything needs to go on the same level, because this, at a later stage, it will have to be bonded or plasterboard or whatever. We are going to decide what is best at that time. But at the moment, everything is broken. Everything is demolished, and yes, that's not bad, but there is a surprise. So right now, if we are going to go in the next room, we are going to have another one which you need to do. And yes, this is going to be the next job. So let's start. Okay, so we are back. Now the concrete it's hard, and yes, we just have to insert back the bolts that they were concreted in. Yes, I feel the gap that this bracket needs to go in. So this side is going to go inside the wall, because I created a small hole just for this side to go in, and I just filled it with some sand and cement. I have some ready here. And that is filled and ready for the bracket to go. Let me just show it to you. So it's here, this side. I filled it,
now I just have to insert the bracket in. Like I was saying, the cement is already hard. I just have to screw it back in. So let's just insert the bracket. Now the biggest problem on these type of jobs, usually when you need to put the brackets, there is the brick that is missing. So you don't have no space to drill into. So then you have to make a little bit of making good sand and cement. You leave it to get hard, and then either you drill or you drill before and you concrete everything in. That is one bolt, and now I'm just going to leave a little bit of space for the metal plate to go in, and you are going to see that in just a moment. But at the moment I will have to break the other half that is sustaining everything at the moment, because we need to insert the metal plate. So we have to take off all this side, and then we can insert our plate. So let's just do that. So as you see, at the moment everything is loose and the chimney is not falling. And it's never going to fall. If you are going to take it out from a higher point, there is a big possibility that it's going to fall. But because I have a big area that is bricked laid inside the wall, there is no risk of this falling down. So yes. Now what I have to do, just clean it for my metal plate to be nice and level. Okay, so now everything looks okay. We just have to fix the metal plate, and we are going to be safe.
Okay, so I had some problem with the bolts, but now are all tightened and good. Okay, so now everything is on. I will just start to do some making good all around. I'm going to start to do some making good to the bricks that they were loose. Some of them I'm just going to fill them and render them and leave some gaps for the ventilation, for the air ventilation. Pretty much that's it here. So let's just do that. Okay, so let's just do a quick recap of what have we done here till at this point. So to start a job like that, you should first check your local authorities to see if it can be done. Maybe the property is going to be a listed property and definitely you cannot do it. But anyway, you should check with them first. See if there is any need of an application, building control or structural engineer. So once that you have all that paperwork done, all the information from the local authorities like the council, you should have a paper signed with your neighbor, because that is a party wall, and you should have a party wall agreement with your neighbor. Let him know that you are going to do structural work on the wall that is going to divide you from your neighbor. So second thing that you need to do is to buy all the materials and have them ready from when you are going to start the job. First thing that we need to buy is all the metals, and that is going to be our gallow bracket that is here. Then we have our support plate that is at the bottom, exactly this one. It's a metal plate, and then the metal plate support, which is this angle bead that is going to support the metal plate. And also you'll need some sand and cement, and I also used some PVA in the mix to make it more sticky and to do some of the rendering or the repairs that I needed to do, because most of the time some of the bricks are going to get loose and you'll need to put them back, and also a little bit of rendering and filling up the gaps to make the job look a little bit nicer and not have too many gaps. That is going to give even a little bit more support, because most of the time you are going to get small gaps under the metal plate and the support for the galley brackets.
And also you'll need even some raw plugs or even some chemical plugs, you decide. I use the M12 by 60 long, so I can have, so I can put them a little bit in more inside the wall to have more strength and support. And this is what I used. So in the both sides of the chimney breast, I left some ventilation. And you can see it here. So at this point, I can just carry on with all the demolition of the chimney breast. So I'm just going to take out everything that it's still standing.
Woohoo! Almost done. Let's go in the other room. Now I just have that small bit under that still needs breaking. But before, I will have to take all this out. And I put even my mask, because now it's getting worse. Now it's a little bit more dusty than the bit on top. So I will need a mask.
I hope you understand when I'm talking.
Yeah, too much dust.
Oh, okay, so enough with the demolition at the moment. Everything is nice and clean. And now we just have to demolish the ground floor. At the moment, loft done, first floor done, ground floor to do still. Okay, so at the moment I'm just going to demolish this wardrobe here to have more space for making good. And yeah, let's just continue with that. Okay, so now we are trying to do the ceiling. I already put one timber up that is going to sustain my plaster. And I need to put another one here because I'm not going to be able to put it inside that gap and screw it. So I'm just going to put another timber on top and I'm going to have more edging for my screws. Now, a small problem is the gap here. It's about 30 millimeters and my plaster board is just going to be around 15 millimeters and I will have to double it. So in this case, I'm going to try to put one piece of OSB and another one of plaster board so I can cover this gap. But for now, I'm just going to try to put the timber in. Now, because I worked above my head, I have loads of stuff in my eyes now and they are hurting a little bit. So that's why it's always good to have some protection on, especially when you work on the ceilings, because a lot of stuff can fall down in your eyes. And at the moment, I don't want to bother the
hospitals because they are very busy with the coronavirus. But in any case, you should always use your protection. Goggles, gloves, and possibly a mask. Okay, so right now I'm trying to repair the floor, board it up, and I'm trying to do a cut here so I can find the timber at the back. And this should be my line. So on top of this, maybe I'll cut a piece of OSB and just nail it in. Okay, so before closing this floor, I'm just going to clean it a little bit more. There is no need because I'm going to break downstairs, so everything is going to fall downstairs. But I will have less rubbish falling in my head. So yeah, I'm going to try to clean it up now. With the cleaning, just trying to close it down. And that's a perfect fit. Okay. And now I'm just going to do some making good to the floor, and that is going to be our last stage for this floor. Of course, I will have to close down this wall here, but that I'm going to do when I'm going to do the entire room. So what am I doing now? I'm just going to fill some gaps with some screed, sand and cement, sharp sand and cement.
inside. If not, you are going to have a lot of condensation and maybe leaks. So be careful. This is the most important thing that you need to do when you take the chimney blast out, because the water, instead of going all the way downstairs, is going to stop in the loft, and then you are going to have water coming in. And this is one of the ways that you can do it. There are different ways, and this is one of them.
So for the moment, we are going to finish this video. I still need to do all this wall, all the making good here, but I will have to do a partition wall. So I'm going to do a stud wall here because it's the side with the neighbor, and I'm going to try to make it as soundproof as possible because these walls are very thin and you can hear everything. So the client decided that he wants stud wall and with insulation inside and soundproof plasterboard. So that's why I cannot show you this side of wall, the making good of this side, because I will have to do another job to it. But for now, that's it. We have closed the ceiling and we've done the floor, and that's it for our video. And of course, it's going to be a second part of this video, which is going to be about the chimney breast taken down on the ground floor. We still need to do that, but I don't want for this video to be too long. So that's why this is going to be the first part of this video, and then we are just going to do the second part. And what can I say? That's it for now. Be safe and see you on the next one.